To understand the depth of commitment that North Carolina A&T State University has for science, technology, engineering, and math, you have to go back more than 150 years to 1862, when President Abraham Lincoln created land-grant universities throughout the Union. North Carolina A&T is part of that legacy. Founded in 1890, A&T emphasized agriculture and mechanical arts. Today, they call it STEM. And as producer Rick Sullivan shows us, its presence is apparent in every corner of this Greensboro campus.
Curiosity and a thirst for knowledge is being cultivated at North Carolina A&T University. The STEM Early College is a prime example. Talented teenagers receive early exposure to high-level courses in science, technology, engineering, and math. The facilities here are some of the most advanced you will find anywhere in a high school, and the instructors are as eager to teach as the students to learn. These students won't have far to go if they wish to pursue more of this same excellence when they graduate high school. North Carolina A&T welcomes students in many varieties and with many pursuits, but what it does best is channel talent into science and technology.
When students tell us that they want to be a scientist, or they want to be an engineer, they want to get a PhD in microbiology, or they want to go into med school or dental school, then what we do here at North Carolina A&T State University is take those bright students and enhance the probability that they will do exactly what they say they want to do in life.
For Chancellor Harold Martin, an electrical engineer, deciding what he wanted to do with his life was not perfectly clear. When he was one of those talented young students at North Carolina A&T during the 1970s, he just knew he wanted to make an impact, but he needed direction.
I had an opportunity to engage what I consider to be some of the brightest faculty members anyone could ever dream of having. These faculty members took more interest in understanding the future, and more importantly, demanding the very best of me so that I would then be well prepared for whatever opportunities were available for me.
And as North Carolina A&T goes forward, Dr. Martin sees to it those same qualities continue to be a part of the fabric of his alma mater. One of the most successful ways A&T develops well-rounded students is through research, connecting students to meaningful, real-world applications for the work they will soon be doing after college. Dr. Stephanie Luster Teasley, like the Chancellor, was an engineering student here. Now she teaches chemical and civil engineering while also working with her students to improve the environment. She has recently been awarded a patent for technology that could dramatically reduce pollution from hog farm lagoons.
We have a polymer that encapsulates a chemical oxidant and it slowly releases the oxidant over time. So I like to call it an environmental pill. And so it's able to reduce bacteria levels, improve color and odor, so that a farmer could quite possibly use this technology in their lagoon. It will reduce the bacteria levels, so when it rains, nearby waterways will not get contaminated. And because it's biodegradable, when they dredge the lagoon, then they can just compost it. And it's a nice, sustainable, and green technology.
North Carolina A&T has the largest agriculture school among the nation's historically black colleges. Post-harvest technologies are critical pursuits, along with many other sciences like nanoscience and biometallic materials research. These are but a few of the areas where A&T staff and students are questioning and pursuing new ideas every day. This wall of patent winners with A&T connections is proof of the performances from the past and the promises of the future. The impact these students and staff and this school have on the area's economy is profound, and a degree from here will get your foot inside a lot of doors.
Our graduates in the STEM disciplines don't struggle to get a job. Now, you know, years ago they might have been offered a signing bonus, now they actually have to apply to a couple of different companies, but they're getting jobs.
And not just jobs with local companies, but global companies as well, with far-reaching possibilities. Companies that help to partner and fund the kind of research that goes on here.
And there are Fortune 500 companies, you know, all of the major high-tech companies, the aerospace companies, the defense contractors, John Deere, Caterpillar, Cummins. the major companies that are involved in manufacturing or innovation in this country come here and work with us.
In 2010, the university brought together groups of students, faculty, staff, and even partners and friends of the university to better define how to best embrace the great history of the school and to enhance the potential for its future. This broad constituency created a strategic plan it called Preeminence 2020. It's a blueprint for continued success at North Carolina A&T, and its implementation is a great source of pride for Chancellor Martin.
It is unusual to find so many constituents of an institution so knowledgeable and so committed to a direction of an organization and passionate about it as we have with our constituents today. That causes me great excitement and great enthusiasm. And it causes me, quite honestly, to get up every day enthused about coming to work and leading this wonderful institution.
Rick Sullivan is visiting Elizabeth City State University today, and you can see his story on ECSU right here next Tuesday on North Carolina Now.